Haley Morrell, Jason Mayhew, Jordan Molyneux, Jack Mankey, and Colin McMahon.
Okay. This is a short poem about high school. Who do you want to be? You get the choice after all. Pursue your farthest dreams, and there's no stopping your role. This is your chance to pick the rest of your life. Choose what you want, but you got to choose it right. We're told pick who you are, but who you are could be wrong. How is it possible to not know what you want? You are your own captain. It's just... It's just you, literally. But actually, you're sailing into a storm idiotically, and apparently, now the kids are the lazy ones. We're the ones with the problem. We still don't know what's good for us, but I'll tell you what I know. I know that I'm not a nobody. I know what I want to be. I know the people around me and what they will be. But you know what? This isn't the end. It's just the beginning, and we're all going to see each other again. So why worry?
Seven, 8.8, 8.4, 8.4,
8.4, and then 8.8. I need more out of you judges. Come on now.
Okay. Stained socks, drenched in blood and soup, wrung out and left to cry. Hanging by thread spun by monstrous hands, the timer on the microwave then sounds a battle cry. Dainty fingers hold the bowl of steamy noodles while beer mixes with testosterone. Daddy and uncle are looking to spar. Slur, sip, slur, nudge, sip, slur, shove, and that's all it took to stain my socks. Splints of glass spill across hardwood like Adam's ale. A faint scent of chicken fills the room. Broth and blood diffuse over the burnished floor. And I'm just watching them play in stained socks. Through the narrow hallway, they wrangle from room to room, playing leapfrog in the den and hopscotch in the kitchen. Mommy grabs the phone and dials. 911, what's your emergency? The boys are playing rough. I escaped to the porch, but there was no time to change my socks. My voice muted with shock. I search for somewhere to flee. Isolated on this island, the gladiators continue their free-for-all. Lost in an acre of land, lost in the mind of a 7-year-old girl, wondering, will mommy be okay? Will I be sleeping in my bed tonight? Will I ever see my toys again? And will my socks ever be clean? And me silently staring at chopped grass, and mommy screaming at dangerous men, and sirens blaring through thick trees, and alone I am on splintered steps, and a man in uniform escorts me away, and daddy holding his bloody head, and I am still in stained socks.
All right, let's give it up for Haley. We have a 9, an 8.8, an 8.7, a 10, a 9.2, and a 9.2.
Across the audience, mixing black and red, a student lounges. His phone illuminates his face as his classmates pretend not to notice. Some even consider this as approval to partake in the same action. His concentration rarely diverts from the millions of white pixels. Half aware of the poets on stage, half distracted by his high score of 5 on Flappy Bird. Despite his strongest efforts, his eyes begin to wander, mostly at the few other cell phones, but occasionally back to the stage. He texts one of his buddies, "This is stupid, but it's better than English class." Beyond the stage, blending white and tan, a poet quivers. She studies the focused faces, expecting masterpieces. Her fellow teammates seem oddly poised, despite her terror. She glances at the tiny cell phone lights among the seats as if they are fireflies, half insulted by the discourtesy, half relieved by the lessening number of watchful eyes. 9.2, 9.5, 8.9, 8.6, 9.3, and 9.0. The MC, seemingly energized by a pint of coffee, shouts. She inhales until her stomach stiffens with pressure and another fear grasps her core. She whispers the adage to herself, "The points are not the point. The point is the poetry." Her texting classmate remains oblivious to her anxiety. As she steps up to the microphone, he engages in a furious digital battle against Flappy's plumbing. His crafty opponent, the sixth pipe, thwarts him once more, and he curses louder than he means to. Encouraged by the turning heads, he shuts off his phone. His ears absorb the first stanza of the poem, but his mind quickly slips into the wild serenity of a daydream. A sudden mass finger snapping jolts him to the attention. He's forgotten that's a thing they do. 7.5, 5.5, 6.5, 7.0, 6.9, and 7.9. A soul-scrambling series of numbers, if ever there was one. Exiting the stage, she repeats, "The points are not the point. The point is the poetry." Though she can't help but wonder something she has denied herself until this moment. So, what exactly is the point of having the points if the points are pointless? They express artistic value as if it's something that can be quantified, scored, ranked. Then, is art anything more than a competition? Is the poetry, in fact, just a game to get a high score on?
Give it up for Jason. Scores, judges. Ooh, we have a 10, a 9.7, a 9.1, a 10, a 10, and a 10. All right. Our next team up is Rebel Rousers, Ashley Farina, Allie Tellerico, Emily Gers, Lily Abbott, Shreya Timofina. You're still in your arms, so far in love, but I wanna burn with you tonight. Your heart on me. There's two of us, we're certain with desire. The pleasure's pain and fire burns.